Next week, the Minneapolis City Council will vote on whether to approve a new contract for Minneapolis Police. But tonight, new documents show some of its members are now saying their support will hinge on whether the mayor meets several of their demands. The mayor calls their actions inappropriate, saying the council's vote needs to be based in good faith and strictly on what's in the contract. The new contract comes with a big price tag as the department struggles to recruit and retain officers. And how the city pays for it will have an impact on other services and your taxes. Here's Jennifer Hoff.
The city of Minneapolis is at a crossroads as it's facing a nearly $22 million budget shortfall next year and a historic police contract that city council member Latricia Vito says she'll vote to support.
The money and the benefits that we provide to these officers really matter.
The tentative three-year agreement the police union approved this month comes with a 21% pay increase and other reforms, but it needs a majority of the council to sign off on it, and that's no guarantee.
People will have zero to little confidence in local government if this doesn't pass.
Sources have said it may also lead to 150 more officer retirements when the department is already down hundreds. But paying to retain and recruit more means City Operations Officer Margaret Anderson Kelleher is proposing reallocating $9 million to help pay for the contract and offset property tax levies from rising as much as 7%.
It'll fall differently on different types of property across the city. And that's why we're trying to use this money wisely.
The money is part of the $19 million the state gave the city last year for public safety. And there may now be less of it to fund other community initiatives, including cultural district ambassadors and racial injustice workers.
All these ideas are good. Don't get me wrong. We're not arguing about the ideas. We're looking at the funding, but I also hope they understand what this contract brings.
There are several meetings next week where council members will not only be discussing the budget, but that tentative agreement. All eyes, though, will be on the city council meeting Thursday morning, where those members will have to vote on whether to approve or reject that contract. In Minneapolis, Jennifer Hoff, Care 11 News.